In this video, we are going to build entire advanced semantic search from scratch by using new updated ElasticSearch 8.11, and also we are going to use GPT 3.5 turbo models. Here we are going to use OpenAI embeddings as well. So first we will see how different advanced semantic search is from the normal semantic search. Then we will see the complete architecture of the code, and at the end we will do the coding. So without any further ado, let's begin. What is different in advanced semantic search than normal semantic search? So let's say we have an apparel e-commerce website and we have some products, their description, their color, their price and their gender to which the product belongs to. So first, in normal semantic search, what we do, we just convert all the descriptions into vector, and then we also convert the user query. Let's say user has searched for blue t-shirt for men under 2K. We convert this as well into the vector, and then we do vector similarity and we show the results in order of vector similarity score. But in advanced semantic search, what we are going to do, we are going to pass this blue t-shirt for men under 2K query into the GPT model to get this JSON output. So in a recent OpenAI dev day, they have announced the JSON mode for GPT models. And by using that, we can get consistent JSON output. So here we are going to give this prompt to tell us what color, what gender, what is the maximum price and what is the minimum price user has searched for in their query. So in this query, blue t-shirt for men under 2K, the model should give us color blue, gender men, max price 2000 and minimum price 0. By using this JSON values, we can further filter out the normal semantic search results to get more accurate and precise results for the user. So that is how we are going to make advanced semantic search. Let's discuss the architecture. So first, we are going to convert name and the description into the vectors by using text embedding ADA002 model. So the thing is, till Elasticsearch 8.7 or 8.8, the limit of vectors was 1024. But GPT gives you the dimension of vector as 1536. That is why earlier it was not possible to use GPT embeddings inside Elasticsearch because the limit was 1024 only. But in Elasticsearch 8.11, they have increased this limit from 1024 to 4096. And now we can use GPT embeddings also because the size is 1536. So first we'll convert name and the description into the embeddings, and then we'll store complete data inside the Elasticsearch. Once this is done, now come to the user part. So let's say user has searched for blue t-shirt for men under 2K. So what we are going to do here, we are going to pass this blue t-shirt for men under 2K, same thing in the GPT embedding. And this is going to give us the vector, or we can call embedding of user query. And then we are going to use this in the search. Now the interesting part, we are going to pass this user query into GPT-3 large language model, and we are going to use JSON mode as well. And by using this, we are going to get this output, like what kind of color, what kind of gender, what kind of price this user is searching for. Using this JSON, we are going to filter out the results. So here we are going to do semantic search using filters inside the Elasticsearch. And then final results will be shown to the user. So this is the complete architecture. Now let's start coding. Here I'm using the Myntra product catalog. I'm going to give the GitHub link of the entire project in the description of this video. You can check that out, including the dataset. Now let's, first we need to install some libraries like pandas, OpenAI and Elasticsearch. So which I did, we just run this code. Now here I'm using only 500 rows of the data for the sample. Now we can remove the none values from this data. Now it got reduced to 468. So here in this step, what I was doing, actually when I was looking at the data, I saw the name contains so much information about the product. So that's why I thought we can combine the name and the description into one column, which I did here. And this was just, I was looking at the data. Now we can get the embedding of the text using OpenAI's text embedding. So here is the code for it. So here is my OpenAI API key. You need to generate your own API key. So if we go here and if we check, I have created, I'm using this code and you can also use this code. Here I'm using this model text embedding ADA200. I will give you all these links in the description as well so that you can check that out yourself. So here, this is the function which will give you the embedding. So I will just run this function once, and if you want to check how this embedding is looking, we will just embed a normal word called magic. And if we see the sample embedding length, you can check it is 1536. So this is how it is. If you're concerned about the pricing, so here is the pricing as well. So I was looking at the pricing. So let's just check the pricing as well. This is the embedding model which we are using, ADA V2 0.0001 per 1000 tokens. So it's actually very cheap. Now just come to this. So I have already created, if we see this code, I have already created the embedding of name description column, and I have saved it in a new column called name description vector. And here you can do it. And I have saved this entire data set along with the embedding into this embedded.csv file. So I will just comment it out. I don't want to run this again. Here you can see embedded.csv file, and this file contains the vector data as well. Now we need to insert this data into the Elasticsearch. So what we'll do, we'll just connect to Elasticsearch here. So I will just run this. It is coming false. That means I have to run my Elasticsearch first. So in this directory, I have installed the Elasticsearch. This is user Abid Sadagar downloads and Elasticsearch. So from here, I will just run my Elasticsearch. Once my Elasticsearch is up and running, and if we run this code, it will give me true. So I think it is running. Let's just check. It is running. I think it will take some time. And I think it is done once again. I think it is done. Let's just check once again. And this is true now. Now I have created the mapping as well to create the index. So to insert the data into Elasticsearch, first we need to create the index along with the mapping. So here is the index mapping. You can think of it like a schema of a relational database. So here is the mapping. You can see all the fields which we have in our database, we are using that. And here is the important thing. Name description vector is a dense vector type field, and the dimension here is 1536. In the recent video, we have used BERT embeddings, and the dimension there was 768. But right now the dimension is 1536, which is supported by Elasticsearch 8.11. So I have already created the index, so I will not run this code. I will just import all these things. I have already created the index, so no need to run this again. I have already used, I'm fetching this data again, pd.read.csv from this embedded.csv file. And I'm using this thing, apply eval, apply np.array. So while I was inserting the vectors inside the database of Elasticsearch, I was getting an error. And then I saw the documentation, and here you need to do this to convert this first embedding, apply eval, apply np.array to convert it into an array format and then insert it. So then it will work. So I already did that as well. No need to do it again. And here I have converted all the docs into the records. So I have converted this pandas data frame into JSON like format, key value type format, which is quite important for Elasticsearch. So that also I have done, and I have indexed all this data into Elasticsearch by using this code. For doc, in docs, try es.index, and this is my index name, my products, document equal to doc, id equal to doc, product id. So we already have id, so we are using that. And now if we check how many documents are present in the Elasticsearch index my products, it will show us 468. So that is done. Now comes the interesting part. Now we can search the data from the index. So here input keyword is blue shoes for men under 2K. If we run this, so what this is going to do, this is going to convert this text into the vector as well. I'm using this function again. And here is the query. So this is the normal query of Elasticsearch, where field is name description vector, and we are passing the query vector inside this search field. Here K means how many results we want to get and number of candidates. Like this is how many candidates this algorithm is going to get applied to. So here we are passing 500 because the maximum number is 500. Here is the query es.knn search, index is my products, knn equal to query. So this is the query which we are passing in, and we want the output fields like product name, description, primary color, price and gender. So we run this, and if we see the results, so here are the normal semantic search results. So as you can see, blue shoes for men under 2K. And let's see what this results are giving us. So if we see ID men, navy blue, solid leather, mid top sneakers. So the normal semantic search is working very good here as well. And if we see the primary color is blue as well, and the price is there also. So if we go down here, here you can see men, navy blue, leather, derbies, and the price is 2685. So here the semantic search fails actually, because it is giving us the products which are price above 2000. Which should not be the case. And also if we go down, we can see there are some brown color things as well. So if you see primary color equal to brown. So now the advanced thing which we are going to do, we are going to apply semantic search results a filter. So on the same thing, we can apply some filter. So let's say minimum price here is, so this is the same query actually, which we have used above. And now we are going to apply minimum price equal to 0 and maximum price equal to 2000 and the gender equal to men. So here I'm using only one filter. Let's just skip the color filter right now. And this is how the filter query looks like. So this is the filter query. I'm using the bool here. This is the Boolean query. And there's a must thing. You can refer to the documentation of Elasticsearch to understand in detail what exactly is going on here. So I'm just going to give you the high level overview. So this is the filter query. So basically we are going to filter out the results of semantic search by using this filter query. and this is how it works. And I'm passing in the range filter as well. So I want the price. I want the products which belongs to, which fall under minimum and the maximum price between those ranges. So here is the es.knn search, my products, body equal to Q1. And this Q1 is actually this. This is the Q1 and request timeout equal to 5,000. This is the second and filter equal to filter query. So here we are passing the filter query. And if we run this and if we see, so all the results which are priced above 2000 got filtered out. So if we see here, price is 1286, 749, 1799, 1286. You will not see any product which is priced above 2000. So this is there. But right now, here what we did, we have defined this filter manually. Like I have understood it myself based on the query and I have defined it. Now how we can do it by using the LLM, the GPT model. So here what I'm doing, I'm just getting what all distinct primary colors are present in our data set, and the same thing with the gender. So these are the distinct values of gender and distinct values of primary color present in our data set. So here we will do blue shoes for men under 2K. Same thing. And we will run this as well. So why I have done this color list and gender list, I will show you. So here is my prompt. So I have given the prompt. I have a data in Elasticsearch of all the clothing products with their description, color, price, and the gender they belong to. Genders are gender list. So this gender list, unisex, women, men, boys, girls, I'm passing it here. This is the F string. So this variable is going to get fetched from here. Same thing, colors are, price can be anything from 0 to 100K. This is just the random number, maximum price. We can find out using the data as well by using min max function, but I'm just taking it here for the sake of example. And based on the user's search query, give me JSON output as follows. So here is the JSON output format, which I told the GPT to give me. So color, it should be what user want, give, not mentioned, not explicitly mentioned the color in query. If the color mentioned by user is not present in the above color list, give, not found. Same thing, gender. Gender should be from above list only. If not specified, give, not mentioned. And max price and min price. So this automatically get understood by the GPT model. So here I was trying it out and I was checking how the results are looking. And I saw in my testing that results are good in that way as well. So if I run this, this is my prompt. So gender list is not defined. So let's just define the gender list. Embedded DF is not defined. We need to define because we have not ran that code. So I will just go up and I need to define this thing. I will define this. Once that is done, we will go and run this code again. This should work. And now this prompt will work. So this prompt is looking good. Now here is the interesting part. So now I am giving chat completion method of the OpenAI. Here I have made the client, the same client which we have used for embedding as well. So here is the client, OpenAI, and here's the API key. I will delete this API key before publishing the video. So don't worry about that. Now let's come to our important code. So here is the code. And the new thing is response format equal to type JSON object. So this is the new thing which OpenAI has introduced in the recent dev day they have announced. So I have the documentation open here as well. So we can see. So if we go to text generation and here is the JSON mode. So here's the JSON mode and this is the new actually. So I will share all these links as well in the description so that you can read it yourself and go deep dive into it. So this is the code. Now we will just run this code and this should work. Here I'm passing my prompt as well. So let's see how this will give us the results. Query here is blue shoes for men under 2K. So the same thing actually. And this is done. Now if we check here by running this code and if we see color equal to blue, gender equal to men, maximum price is 2000, which gets updated and the minimum price is 0. This is really good actually. So this JSON is in a text format. We need to use JSON library to load it in a proper JSON format. And if we run this, we will get this color blue, gender men, max price 2000, minimum price 0. And now we can use these variables instead of our manual filters, which we did earlier. So here I'm using filter map color. So as you can see, filter map is the JSON and this is the color. So I'm using this filter map equal to color, filter map minimum price, filter map maximum price, same thing. And now we can run this code to get the results. So here all the filters which we have chosen, there's no results belong to that filter. So let's see, we can change, if we can change something. So let me see any other product. Let's say we have product men brown solid sneakers and this is inside 1286 and the primary color should be brown. Okay, so we will search for it. Brown shoes for men under 2K. Let's just search this, same thing prompt again, same thing. We will get the JSON as well, brown, gender, maximum price. We will load the JSON. Once the JSON gets loaded, we will use this code again, and it is not showing any results. Why this is not showing any results? Oh, here I'm doing the blunder. This is the primary color and I have used the gender here. So I will just change this and this should give me the results. Yes. So that was the error. Now let's check if everything is getting fulfilled. So ID men, brown solid leather, mid top sneakers. And here is the men part is here and the price is also here and the primary color is brown. So here I'm using just the primary color. You can add one more filter here of the gender as well. And also the brand name. So if we see the data here, I will show you the data once. We have brand name as well. And the brand name is DKNY. So there are different kinds of brand and you can make filter of those brands as well by using this same logic. I have just used primary color and the range brand. If I choose to see in this, let's say in this results, we will see there is a price called 1197 and there is price called 1785. So let's say I just want the results under 1500. So I will give the prompt under 1500. I will just run this. I will run the prompt again. I will run everything once again and I will see the results now. So let's just wait for it. This is running. This is done. And the results are here. So in these results, you will not see any product which is priced above 1500 because the GPT model has detected the maximum price perfectly fine here based on our query, which is 1500. So this is how you can make advanced semantic search by using Elasticsearch and GPT models. Here we have used OpenAI embeddings and for that we need to share our data with OpenAI. If you do not want to share your data with any other platforms like OpenAI, you can use BERT embeddings. It works completely offline and they have quite good accuracy as well. I have made the video about that as well. You can check that out. Hope you found this video helpful. Thank you so much.